lesson children. Before this, you know, before the vacation, we have done one lesson that is about how the daddy played ping pong. Hope everybody have completed their class works and composition and even the grammar book also. I don't want to have any incomplete works in the first lesson children, because we are shifting to the second lesson. Okay, so please do not keep any pending works in the previous lesson. And coming to this lesson, and what is the lesson title? How I taught my grandmother to read. And this story is not only interesting, but also it is inspiring to children. And this lesson was written by Sudhamurthy. You know about Sudhamurthy? Sudhamurthy is one of the great writer in India, who is not only well known for literary works, she has written many books in Kannada and also in English children. And she is the chairperson of Infosys. And she has backed many prestigious awards like Padma Shri Award, Rajalakshmi Award, and also Best Teacher Award too. She is such a famous writer in those days. Not only those days, these days also she is the well-known writer in India. Okay, and coming to this lesson is totally based on two important characters. And we cannot talk more about the Sudhamurthy because of lack of time. So today what I do is, I'll give you some work. So what is the work I want to allot you is, collect some information about the Sudhamurthy children. Her career, her achievements, and her social works. Okay, so whatever you feel interested, you just please collect some information. Tomorrow in the class, we discuss that. Okay, so coming back to the lesson, this lesson is very interesting. And you know one more thing, this lesson is translated into 15 languages children. So from this we can guess, this lesson is going to be very interesting. Okay, and this lesson is based on two important characters. One is a granddaughter and one is grandmother. Grandmother, about this lady? This lady decides at the age of 62 to read. It's really, really really we should appreciate for that. Because nobody will take such a risky decision at the age of 60 years. After 60, you know, their health and their age will not support to complete all these things. But here, this lady is something special and she has decided to do something at the age of 62. So what is that she has decided? She has decided to read at the age of 62 children. So hats off to her, right? And who has helped her? Her granddaughter helped her to read. Okay, so here we go into the lesson. And before I start this lesson reading, I want you to answer to my question. And my question is, would you like to help your grandparents? You know, old people. I think yes, because you are very good children, I know that. Please help the old people children, because at that age, because of their old age, they will be, you know, very weak. They are very weak and old. They cannot do some works of their own. So they need to depend on somebody. So whenever they are in need, so please help them. Okay. So this is also one of the good habit you need to cultivate children. Okay. Hope so you will follow this. Helping the old people. Are your grandparents? Good. And coming to this lesson, shall I start? Okay. Look into the lesson, children. Read about how a grandmother's determination make a young girl teach her how to read. So this lesson already told, there are two characters, that is grandmother and granddaughter. So granddaughter, how she will help the grandmother to read, we'll see into the lesson by going into the details of that. When I was a girl of about 12, I used to stay in a village in North Karnataka with my grandparents. And who is this little girl who was just 12 years? Can you guess, children, who is she? She is none other than Sudhamurthy. She is the author of this lesson and she is a narrator of the lesson. And she wants to share something from her childhood. So when she was 12 years, she used to stay with her grandparents in a small village in Karnataka, children. Okay, so coming to the next lines. Those days the transport system was not very good. So we used to get the morning paper only in the afternoon. You know, in the olden days, how the transport system was? The transport system was very poor, children. So that is why they used to get the newspaper in the afternoon hours. And when we get the newspaper, children, we get the newspaper in the early morning. That is in between 6 to 7, right? because of facilities we have, well-developed transport system we have. Okay, and in those days, if anyone wants to visit their relatives or somebody, they may take some hours of time to reach their place. But now we have types of transport. Within fraction of hours, we can even cross the borders of India. So, well-developed transport system we have in India, children. Okay, not only in India, everywhere in the world. But in those days, the transport system was poor. So, that is why they used to get the newspaper in the afternoon. The weekly magazine used to come one day late. All of us would wait eagerly for the bus, which used to come with the papers, weekly magazines and the post. Here, when they used to get the weekly magazines also they get one day late. And here the people in Karnataka, that is in this village, they will be waiting for the bus to come. As soon as the bus arrives, they want to collect the newspapers and the magazines and also the post, children. You know about the post? Yes? In the olden days, the people wants to depend on inland letters and also the post, children. So why they used to depend on the post and inland letters? For communication purpose. To know the information. Okay, to know the, whatever they need, whatever they are expecting from them to know, they used to write and send the letters to them, children. Through that method, they used to communicate with them. But now, we have an easiest communication. Okay, so what is it? Easiest communication we have? Mobile. Okay, with the help of a mobile, we can send information or any one small message within a fraction of seconds. Okay, because of well-developed technology we have. Technology is developed. And in the olden days, technology is not developed. So, they used to depend on the postcards or the inland letters. As soon as the bus arrives, they collect all this material and they want to know the latest updates and also the information from their near and dear ones. And coming to the next paragraph, children. At that time, Triveni was a very popular writer in the Kannada language. She was a wonderful writer. Her style was easy to read and very convincing. And in those days, there is one great writer, children. Who is she? Triveni. Okay, Triveni is one of the great writer in those days. And her writings are very interesting to these Kannada people. Because the way she writes. Okay, it is not only easy to understand, but also it is convincing. So why it is easy and convincing? Easy means maybe the lady is using a very simple language and also the things where she will share in the stories, maybe it is based on their day-to-day lives. Okay, so people after reading they are easily convinced with the words and convinced with the ideas and the views of the writer. Okay. Her stories usually dealt with complex psychological problems in the lives of ordinary people and were always very interesting. You know what type of story she used to pick up? She used to pick up those things where, psychological problems are the common problems of the ordinary people. You know what the problems will be faced by the ordinary man or a common man. These problems she will share in the stories. I think this is the one way the Kannada people are crazy about. Because it is related to their lives. So that is why they are taking more interest to read these novels. Unfortunately for Kannada literature she died very young. Even now after 40 years people continue to appreciate novels, her novels. Unfortunately, you know what is it? Unfortunate thing happened. Triveni was died at a very young age, children. At a very young age. But after the death of that woman, still, this Kannada people did not forget her. And still, they want to read the novels of Triveni after some 40 and 50 years also. Okay, she died long, long, long back. But after the death of 40 to 50 years also, the Kannada people did not forget her. Okay, still they are reading the novels of Triveni. And from here we can understand one thing. They have a very good attachment towards this writer, children. Okay, and this passage is completely dealing about the Triveni and her writings and unfortunate death of the writer. And